Turkey's inflation soars to a 19-year high of 36.1% as a financial turmoil grips the country. The rise was driven by skyrocketing costs of transport and food. Most central banks have raised interest rates to tame inflation, but Turkey has gone the other way with President Tayyip Erdogan's unorthodox rate-cutting policies that triggered a currency crisis. Turkey's lira shed off 44% of its value last year as the central bank slashed interest rates to prioritize credit and exports over currency and price stability. Erdogan now says government is determined to lower inflation into single digits. Some economists predict Turkey's inflation could reach as high as 50% unless the direction of its monetary policy is reversed.
Tech giant Apple welcomes the new year with a new milestone. The iPhone maker officially becomes the first company to hit the $3 trillion stock market value. Apple shares touched $182.88 on the first trading day of 2022, just enough to break above the $3 trillion ceiling, as investors bet consumers will continue to shell out money for its products. Apple previously shared the $2 trillion market value club with Microsoft. Other tech giants like Alphabet, Amazon, and Meta platforms have market value of about $1 trillion. And over in the U.S., the Food and Drug Administration has cleared Pfizer's booster shot for children aged 12 to 15 years old. More in this report.
As COVID-19 cases continue to skyrocket in the U.S., the FDA on Monday authorized a third dose of the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine for kids aged 12 to 15 and for 5 to 11-year-olds who are immunocompromised. The agency also narrowed the time for all booster shots to 5 months instead of 6 months after the primary doses, saying a shorter window could offer better and quicker protection against the Omicron variant. COVID cases are surging due to the highly transmissible variants, which health officials say could quickly overwhelm hospitals. Studies show boosters appear to be protective against Omicron. Two shots of the mRNA vaccine are about 35% effective against Omicron, but a booster dose increases effectiveness to 75%, according to the CDC, based on data from South Africa and the United Kingdom. In authorizing boosters for young teens, the FDA said it reviewed data on the safety of a third dose provided by the Israeli Ministry of Health, including data from over 6,300 individuals 12 to 15 years of age who received a Pfizer shot.
Now, Israel will start reopening its doors to foreigners from 199 countries deemed medium risk next week. But that's only if the travelers can prove they are vaccinated or have recovered from COVID-19. Now, the move, which partially reverses a ban imposed in late November in response to the fast-spreading Omicron variant, comes after Israel approved a fourth dose of the Pfizer vaccine to medical staff and people over the age of 60.